In Brick Lane, Monica Raleigh tells the story of Nazneen, a young Bangladeshi woman who moves to London's Tower Hamlets area to enter into an arranged marriage with an older man. The novel covers three main areas of Nazneen's life: her initial arrival and attempts to acclimatise to her new life with her husband, Shanu, the birth and early death of her son from meningitis, but the majority of the book focuses on the year 2001-2, by which time Nazneen has two preteen daughters and has entered into a relationship with Karim, a young Muslim radical. This stage of the novel plays out against several different events: Shanu's attempts to raise money to take the family back to Bangladesh, much to the chagrin of their eldest daughter; the family's struggle to repay a financial debt to Mrs. Islam, a local moneylender whose elderly, frail nature serves to cover her almost psychotic desire to get what she is owed; and the increasing racial tensions on the Tower Hamlets estate between Karim's group, the Bengal Tigers, and the far-right nationalist group, the Lionhearts. The great strength of this novel is that it takes characters that could easily be dismissed as clichés: the dutiful young Muslim wife, the pompous, foolish, older Muslim husband, the young radical, and makes them into something vital, real, and understandable. Nazneen's development over the 15 or so years that the novel covers make her a most likable heroine, a woman who gradually comes to understand that she has the means to take control of her life here in the UK, but who has the perspective to understand what drives the men in her life. This serves to make sure that Shanu and Karim become more than caricatures. Shanu, with his unfailing optimism that better times are ahead, and that such and such a qualification or job will lead to the success that will see the family return in triumph to Bangladesh, is a modern-day Micawber, but it's impossible not to feel moved by his realization that his time is passing, and that both the UK and modern Islam have been set at a pitch that he cannot hope to match. Karim, too, is a far more complex character than he might otherwise have been in less skilled hands. A committed Muslim, dedicated to fighting the rise of fascistic far-right nationalist groups like the Lionhearts, his story reminded me of things that I'd forgotten about perceptions of Muslims in 2001. I was reminded that in the months preceding September the 11th, riots that took place in Bradford and Oldham played out against the backdrop of concern at the advances that far-right political groups had made in such areas. Were Asian and Muslim youth justified in taking to the streets in such numbers? Was the progress made by the likes of the BNP a threat to the multicultural society that the country seemed to be broadly aspiring to? This review is not the forum for such a debate, but I guess that the fact that the BNP and other such parties have made such lamentable progress in the last two general elections shows where the majority of sympathy has lain, despite the potential game changers of 9/11 and 7/7. I also think that this speaks well of the British people. Ali uses such events as a backdrop to her story, but they never overwhelm it, and the focus remains fixed on the individuals. Bulking her story out with memorable characters such as Dr. Azad, a local GP that Shanu seeks to impress for reasons that are never quite clear until their mutual dependence is revealed later in the book; Razia, Nazneen's cynical friend who greets news of Nazneen's affair with practiced unconcern, and why would she not when her husband has died from having frozen meat fall on him while her son grapples with heroin addiction. Bangladesh is represented by letters from Hasina, Nazneen's sister, who rejected an arranged marriage for a love marriage and has had to live with the consequences ever since. I must admit, I read Brick Lane for slightly personal reasons, given that I work there one day a week, and I felt a frisson of excitement at the mention of Commercial Street, where I work on Tuesday mornings. But Ali's novel is more than just a work of literary tourism. Instead, it provides an insight into an area of London that is hidden and unknown to so many of us who live here. And for that, it will stand as a classic of its kind.